The captain strides to the crease with his team in a lot of trouble. 5 wickets down, 41 on the board.
Trinbago Knight Riders, if they got good memories, will know that 2 years ago he smashed 100 against them, made in 42 deliveries. And that was at Warner Park, when he hit 11 sixes. So he's capable of wreaking absolute havoc. And TKR would know that.
Yeah, a lot of muscle in that bottom hand. Much needed boundary. They need at least a couple and over here to keep up with this run rate.
Well, it's unconventional. It's just giving room and it's very muscular. But it works.
And the key thing that Gabriel tried, there are a lot of teams bowled short at Andrew Russell. They tried to get the ball high because it props onto the front foot and tries to play the pull and the hook. Sometimes it gets him in trouble, sometimes he smashes it out the ground.
Four players on the boundary, on the onside now for Russell. He's followed him. That's going to be four wides.
It's a no ball
as
well.
Corrected, hasn't it?
Well, you'd like to think that their fingers are so wet with sweat that it's that ball has slipped out of their hands, but. He called wide first, didn't he? Now he's called it no ball. So free hit has been signaled here.
So no change in the field for this free hit. Goes for the slower one. It is a rankful toss once again. It might even be another no ball. And it's gone all the way for a hero maximum. Well, let's go with the Michael Jackson calls here, because that's an absolute thriller for another hero maximum.
Seamless.
Billie Jean couldn't have hit this better. It gone, it's gone miles over that stand, is it? What a crack off the bat for that hero maximum.
You could just sense that Ramden, Lynn were baiting Russell just before this delivery. A lot of chatter going on. He kept his cool, he kept his focus. That's gone into orbit.
Again, gone. Hero maximum, second deck.
One of the most economical and tightest bowlers in the world is bowling to one of the biggest hitters going around. And it's a tantalizing battle at the moment. Because at 4 for 16, Dre Ross had an opportunity of coming in and affecting things a little bit more as he brings up his 50 off just 22 deliveries. That is the fastest. The fastest prior to this was just in the other innings, Brendan McCullum.
Oh my! Is this game still alive here with Dre Ross? And he looks at the toe of his bat. He mishit it. That's why it's still in the oval.
Yes, yes it is, Ian Bishop. It is with this man at the crease, particularly when he hits Hero Maximus at the start of the over. Releases the pressure, relaxes him. When he is relaxed, the ball tends to go a very long way.
Right, just going round the wicket, Dwayne Bravo. Is he going to go full and wide, either Yorker wide or pace off the ball wide? Ooh, there's a bit of swerve and curve on that. Bravo and the umpire were in danger.
Umpire signaling four, but I think he's also calling for a helmet. That was hit as hard as I've ever seen a cricket ball hit. And ask him to fetch it.
Another one. And I think you've got to go wide, Tom. I think you've got to find a way to take six out of the equation or try to minimize it. When you bowl straight at him, he's just too good tonight.
There's two things I think are your options. One is what you're talking about is wide, slow ball, wide Yorker. The other option is change of field and drop fine leg back and bowl at his body. Short at his body and change your pace from there. Four more. Backward a point, sliced away.
Just watch it sail over the boundary once again.
Well, it's hit yet another one, and that is now double figures of Hero Maximus. 10 in his 87.
It looks like it was brilliantly caught in the crowd on the second tier. Just missing that Yorker length and Russell being able to get underneath it and hit it well back into the stand.
Kennar Lewis has been relatively a spectator watching this. He's got 1-6 and 1-4. I think you can add another four there, so that's two.
And this is important that he does contribute. It can't be down to just Andre Russell hitting boundaries. So Lewis has done a fine job by getting Russell on strike, but he needs to be able to club a few boundaries of his own just to be able to keep pace.
Yeah, it was good awareness, because I think if he was on strike at the start of the over, he'd look for the single to get Russell on strike, but he's now realised, having faced the fourth delivery and just seven runs coming from it, he needed to go.
Clubbed again, hard, very hard. It's four more. And it's gone quiet inside the Queen's Park Oval. They're not applauding any of these boundaries.
And we're just starting to see a few more yellow tops standing up in the crowd as well. Jamaica Tallawah fans sensing that there could be a miraculous win here. And the guy who's helping them out tremendously now is Lewis. Put the four, then put pressure on Searles, picked up two wides. Extra delivery now has gone for a boundary.
Oh, it's huge. It is massive. A Hero Maximus, that is number 11 for Andre Russell. That equals the CPL record. He's done it before with 11, and it was against the Knight Riders. Chris Gayle and Evan Lewis have also hit 11 in a single innings. Slower, he's waited for it. His 100 comes up with his 12th six. And it is now the fastest century in CPL history. 100 exactly of 40 deliveries. This is astonishing batting from Andre Russell.
Well, it's a reserved El Dorado celebration because he's got other things on his mind. Yes, he has been brilliant right throughout this 100. Just 40 deliveries to get to three figures. But he has other figures at the forefront. He needs 40 still off 21 to get his team over the line.
Squeezes it out. It was the Yorker intended. And he squeezes out a boundary.
Well, that's the issue with that wide line I mentioned in the previous over from Bravo. If he is going to bowl that wide line, it was perfectly executed. Yorker, wide of off stump, right up there. Angle of the bat. He's just got to beat the short third man. And there's plenty of space between the point and short third man, and he finds yet another boundary. Round the wicket.
Drags it round. He's going to get four here. A boundary to Lewis, his fourth four.
And he's coming to the party with some important boundaries in the last couple of overs. It's been absolutely critical. Once he's got on strike, he has taken the chance and heaved the ball, and again in the same area. It's all gone to that straight mid-wicket region where he's hit three fours.
And as you mention it, Dwayne Bravo's just plugged that gap in that mid-wicket slog area. Well, this time it's a better strike. It's way over long on for a hero maximum. It's his 50. What a good innings this is from Kennar Lewis. The 200 comes up, and the Tallawahs need 22 from 15.
Such an important innings from Lewis. That is a brilliant shot. Kept his shape, opened his front leg up, didn't try and overhit it.
Is this enough on it? No, I don't think it is. Great catch. Javon Searles takes a really fine catch. And there was pressure on him to hold on. And this crowd that's gone quiet suddenly finds something.
Try to go again, just falling away as he tries to connect with it. Therefore, mistiming it. A good catch from Searles. A partnership of 161 comes to an end. An innings of 51 comes to an end, and a very good one from Lewis. It's 202 for six.